it's the next day. Ugh. Suppose we should be heading out. Destroy that. Pack that up. Let's get going, Inigo. So I literally had to sit here the whole day. So yeah, I woke up yesterday ready to go, and nope. Oh good, that's already coming up. Fuck off. I just bought an orb weaver, and my hand rest thing is already peeling up. Like, you gotta be kidding me. Okay. Let's grab that. Grab that. Alright. It is 8:30. We should be able to see the sun. Well, we would if we were facing the right way. Ah, there it is! Ah. Lovely, isn't it? So I have to try to remember where the hell it was I was going. Ah, yes. We were going all the way over there for bounties. We are passing by a house. Seems to be burned down, but it's flying a banner. Yellow. Hi.
Look, I'm just here to keep watch. What you're looking for is down inside.
Is it? Hello.
If you're buying, go on in. Otherwise, shove off.
Buying. Ah. Well, do you mind if I warm myself by your fire for a bit? It's been... Ah, yes, that's nice. Never mind. So I know what this place is, I know why it's here and what its purpose is, but I'm genuinely curious on whether or not I can do anything in here.
Hold it. If you're going downstairs, you keep your weapons to yourself, or we'll be getting better acquainted. Head on in and behave yourself.
Don't worry, sir. As you can see, I am holding no weapons. I have no weapons on me. No weapons here. No sirree.
Oh, welcome. Welcome. I don't believe we've seen you here before, have we? You can buy from me and join any booth you like.
It's quite nice for a game.
Hmm? What is this?
Wait, you're serious? This is the Redwater Den. Purveyors of the best skooma outside of Balmora.
Oh, really? And how about a sample?
Since it's your first time. Sure. Find a booth and enjoy.
Yes. Redwater skooma. Here's the thing, Inigo. I know you had a problem with skooma. I, however, have a tolerance to it. And if this is what I think it is, pure undiluted skooma, then we are going to have a problem. Is this taken? Oh no, this is where you poof. We don't want to be in here.
I am in your way.
Yes.
I am sorry.
It's okay, Inigo. Yeah, this is where they poop. This is where this guy poops. Tons and tons of disgusting addicts. I have to know. Hold on. We have to shield ourselves against the evil that is skooma. Ah, I have just cast a spell that should shield me from its poisonous effects. Where is it? Is it a food? Where is it? There it is.
Ah, this place smells funny.
Well, I don't feel too great.
Horsehounds can't resist after they get a taste of your toasts.
The water from the spring makes the skooma so much more potent. We'll have all the thralls we'll ever need. Good thing the boss heard that old farmer running his mouth off in the tavern about finding this place.
Oh god, I feel really, really, really bad. Oi! Oh god, you're wearing ebony.
I don't converse with my prey. I don't converse with my prey.
You're wearing full-on ebony. Oh good lord. This could be bad.
I don't converse with my prey.
Inigo? Telekinetic hand. Ooh. Staff of Fire Rune. I might really regret this. Somehow I don't think that's gonna work here. Well, it did work. Oh god. Yeah, that did not work out too well at all. I'm gonna die. Ah. No, I keep pressing the wrong button. Right. Note to self, do not do drugs. This place answered any questions that I would have. Whether or not I should start doing Dawnguard stuff. Because, you know, Dawnguard DLC, it's back and forth all across Skyrim. And, you know, my journey's going to take me all over Skyrim. It's inevitable. So I figured, you know what, maybe might as well do that. Get it kind of done out of the way as we're passing by the areas. No. That place just fucked me up instantaneously. We're not ready. Maybe with some better planning, but as it was, you know, I had to escape from prison and all that shit, so... Coming to go, we have adventure! Oh! Okay, what do you got? Well, it's... seems to have passed. Hi.
Greetings, fellow Outlander. If you've come here seeking refuge, you're welcome to stay. Just stay away from the roof. There's a nasty barbarian who lives up there that'll beat your face uglier than a Nord family portrait.
Wait, there's a barbarian on the roof? And why are you down here, if he's up there?
Not at all. Travis keeps to the roof and I stay downstairs. I've convinced him that's the safest place for him to hide. Of course, sometimes I can't help it if some greedy snowbird ambushes me and runs up the stairs. Bravos has killed more than a dozen whiteskins this week. Lifton should send us some boon for cleansing their hold of criminal scum.
Well, I'm detecting some hostility towards the Nords.
Nonsense! I love those blonde-haired billies with their pale skins and vapored eyes and beards that smell like wet fur. And those accents! Who wouldn't want to talk to someone who sounds like they have a drum stuck in their nose? Enough of you. Perhaps you ought to head upstairs after all. A Nord lover like yourself might find a view of this barbaric wasteland scenic.
Well, my good sir. I'm gonna take your coat of Malakath, because it seems like an interesting read. And I shall warm myself by this fire, and take some of your charred skeever meat, and leave you on these words. A man whose heart is filled with hate will find himself dead with no friends. Yes, indeed. That is words of wisdom from a wizard. A very kind wizard, okay? Yes. Now, this barbarian, are you truly so violent? Do you not want to have friends? Well, hello. Oh. Hello?
Can I throw a party or what? another traveler. Bothru usually only sends Nords up here so that I might maim them and feed their carcasses to the wolves. Or maybe he's seen the error of his error-prone ways. Maybe he wants old Dravos to have company to wine and feast and drink to Sanguine's honor.
You don't belong in this realm, and my duty kinda compels me to get rid of you.
Kill me? Don't be absurd. Think of all the children, especially all the Nord fathers of children Bothru will murder. They'll be orphans, and then who will think of them? A generous family who will adopt them and love them? Unthinkable. No, we should continue this raid so that Bothru remains more the merrier, and none the wiser.
What charade?
The kind where you have a seat, drink some wine, and enjoy the view. When you wish to leave, the invisibility potion on the table will allow you to slip past Bothru unnoticed. Or, you may seek to confront him and convince him of his folly, although I would advise against it, as he's not the most pleasant person to talk to.
Yes, I've noticed. So you don't serve Mehrun Stegen?
Oh, I did. I was once a member of the Kinvil cast, roaming the Deadlands in search of things to destroy. Yet it all changed when I was summoned to the Mortal Plane, not by a conjurer, but by a man carrying a large staff shaped like a rose. This old man, he wanted me to crush bandits. Something about his son being killed and molested or beaten to death by them. Real boring stuff. Only these bandits didn't fight like bandits, didn't look like him either, and they all owned wine cellars.
Okay.
I started getting these weird tingly feelings, what mortals call free will. Sure, it went against everything I had ever been taught or stood for, but I was tired of learning and wanted to sit down. So I slew the old man, only to see him rise up out of the ground all shiny, like some sort of skin wraith filled with gold. Turns out his name was an old man after all. It was Sanguine, and he offered me a beer.
Beer? I'd fall to the ends of the earth. You were still bound by your master's will.
Exactly. Sanguine wanted me to betray him so I could betray myself. It's all rather simple if you don't think about it. I'm not clear on what the rules regarding Daedric princes and their subjects are, but what is clear is that Sanguine cares not for rules.
So... okay, so what... why is Bathory trying to kill Nords?
Why else? The man hates fun. It's a disease that inflicts a lot of folks who don't worship Daedra. To them, fun is like encountering a cave bear. It looks warm and fuzzy, but it'll rip your head off and use your neck as a waste bucket. To them, fun is like finding inventive ways to kill yourself. To that I say, death is a small price to pay.
And why is that?
Well, fun can expand to a great many things. Fun can be taking a bath in a cauldron of warm mead, or eating sweet rolls off a tavern wench's bosom. Fun can be riding your horse down a mountain, or pushing it off one if you prefer. Fun can be killing 7 bandits or corrupting 1 priest. Whatever it is, and whatever you're doing, the only question that's important is this. Are you having fun? Tell me the answer to that, and I'll tell you whether or not you should kill yourself.
Oh. Your carousing is obscene and must stop immediately. We should invite Bathory up.
I don't think that's a good idea. In fact, it's a terrible idea. Pretty much the worst idea ever conceived. If there were a conjuration spell that could summon all the terrible ideas in the world and rank them according to terribleness, yours would be first.
I might be able to learn that spell, or at least create it. No, there's no spell creation anymore. So, what's he like when he's angry?
When he gets real ornery, his voice will yell the sort of expletives that make horses stand on their back legs and the bards forget their lyrics. Moons plummet from the sky, and seas will boil with such fury, they'll have to create a new divine to explain the phenomenon. Rabbits will forget how to fornicate, the clouds will forget how to rain, and Ragnar will find his head just to cover his ears. With a single rant, poor Bothru can accomplish all these things. Yet he can't bring himself to smile.
More elf for us. I'm telling the elf right now of your betrayal and... Wait, is that fresh pie? I must rinse my eyes with healing potions after witnessing this debauchery. Well, not that stuck up. Jesus. What exactly, what are you doing up here?
Some sort of party. Are you trying to make me angry? Are there not spirits to drink? Ladies to dance with? Orcs? If this isn't a party, I'd like to attend the parties you go to, and bow to the person who throws them.
Alright. So what's the Prince of Debauchery want with him?
To make him a tool of merriment, of course. Think of us all as a part of a single drunken revel. Each attendee contributes to the overall joy. When a person such as Bothru enters the room, with this special brand of gloom, bitterness, and hate, brings the entire party down. So why not make him a doorman? The one who stands outside the party and checks invitations and knows not what goes on inside.
And those who attend the party, what should we expect to find?
Up here is the roof where happiness was invented, where plates dance with spoons, where the shine met the sun, and the light met the stars.
Uh-huh.
And this is the roof where reservations choke and die, where the scantily clad are merry and glad, and our throats burble with wine.
Okay.
Go cause some trouble.
I don't think I will, but I do think I'll take your axe of heroin, because I'm not sure exactly what it is. Oh. Inigo?
What do you need, handsome?
Hi.
Yes?
Inigo! We got a bit of a problem here.
I will aid you if I can.
Take that.
Fair enough. It will be done.
Yeah, hurry up and take it. Thank you. Now.
Okay, watch my back.
Get up here.
Moving out.
Come on, come up here. We got a bit of a problem. You see, you are a demon. And, we have to banish you. I am terribly sorry about this. You seem like a lovely fella, but, you are a demon, and we're gonna have to, banish you now.
I hope you're not.
Flee! Oh god. Okay, there we go. Holy good fuck, I just have Daedric now. Well, I'll take that. And I'll take that. I'll take that too. All of you are guilty of fraternizing with the demons that are the Daedra. I strongly suggest you all go home as I try to pick this lock and take all this shit.
Yes, I knew you could do it.
Thank you. Inigo's such a good friend. So are we gonna have a problem here?
You came down the steps. What happened up there? How did you manage to survive?
You have been murdering. And, well, unfortunately, I did have to send him back to the Plains of Oblivion. Because, you know, he is a demon. But, you know, for a demon, he was quite cheery.
Cheery? What an Oblivion has gotten into that form. He's not supposed to have a personality. And you're not supposed to be alive. In fact, you were up there for some time. What exactly did Dravas tell you? Whatever it is, I'll have you know my conscience is clear.
Davros told me you're trying to kill off Nords. Why? You must have had some bad experiences upon entering Skyrim. Yeah, I bet the Imperials weren't trying to cut off your head. Maybe they did.
My experience here in Skyrim has conformed precisely to my expectations. People say the only difference between a Nord and a sack of manure is the sack. That is an unforgivable insult to manure. Crops grow from manure that replenishes the soil, and when I drop a load of manure in a bucket, it's generally a pleasurable experience.
Manure does have its uses.
The Nords, meanwhile, are a blight on this land, drum-beating savages whose existence we'd accept if they weren't so sonic noisy. No sooner did I arrive in Windhelm when one such ornery icebard told me to go back to Morrowind. Like all other hornblowers that infest Skyrim, he was insistent this was Nordland when elves were here long before Iceborne was settled. Of course, Nord arguments are won by whoever shouts the loudest, and this one clearly had me bested in that regard. You don't need a dragonborn to tell me that shouting is a frost monkey's greatest weapon.
What's a dragonborn? I have no idea what the hell that is. So did you even brawl the person? Because that's typically how it's done.
Brawl? What purpose would that have served? Do you mean to tell me I could tell you Secundo is a great big melon and I punched you in the face would make it so? That's an even dumber reason for winning an argument than shouting. At least shouting involves words. As expected, in a land of nitwits, the Nords choose their leaders and their laws based on coin flips, fist size, and who can down the most mead.
Size of cocks, too. So what? He told me you're trying to kill the Nords. Why? You just told me. So how did you manage to summon that demon?
I was at the Bean Bob in Riften, plotting my next course of action when I met a man by the name of San Wiven. After a few bottles of mead, I told him my plan to rid the world of snow apes once and for all. Surprisingly, he offered to help. But first, he wanted to play a game. If I managed to solve his riddle, he told me he would provide me with a powerful weapon to attain my goal. With nothing to lose, I accepted his challenge. In the end, the riddle proved rather easy to solve. War stands on four legs in the 10 legs during the day, and is stood upon at night.
stood upon at night. A chair?
While knights often call for man to stand on chairs, it hardly has more than four legs. Nope. It crawls on all fours as a kitty, stands on its toes as it attempts to steal your coin purse, and dies a worthless rug under your feet. Farewell.
Yeah, I'm done talking to you. You hear that, Inigo? We're done talking to him. There is no point talking with someone with such a closed mind. I have things
what
to trade.
Are we trading?
We have things to trade. I have fucking Daedric armor.
Okay, let us get back to it.
Okay, Requiem, right. I might have just fucked up. Because I'm pretty sure Daedric armor is actually cursed. I seem to have forgotten that.
Those frost thieves can smell treasure like a rat smells cheese. Especially if that treasure
was... Oh, come on. You need to get up.
So it done good. My father always said no other master...
Will you shut up? I'm trying to save my friend's life. Okay, well, I couldn't do it. Always trying. I'm gonna have to reload, aren't I, and do this all over again. Alright. Okay. That is out of the way. Let me just... 1 second. This foul armor must be put aside. Okay. Whoop. Inigo, I have something for you.
Yes?
That's yours.
I am sorry. That is beyond me. No.
Can you come here?
It will be done. Moving out.
Okay, no.
You want to talk?
Yeah, take this.
Pooling our resources.
Probably should have put this inside the thing as well, but alright.
All set?
Yep, let's go. We have no business here. The we have vanquished the demon. Banished the demon back to the realms of oblivion. And we are going to ignore the idiotic bigot. Help! This is not good. In they go! Oh God. You all right? You gotta stick by me, bro. I really need to up my restoration some more. Get some better restoration spells. Eventually the restoration will heal up my stamina as well. That would be really useful.
What a lovely day.
It's a little overcast, but you know, I mean, it's there's been worse, Inigo, so I won't disagree with you. Not this time. Come along, my friend.
They gone?
Are you injured? I think you may be injured. There.
Please help. I can pay you.
I just did, though.
Bandits attacked and ransacked my cart. Can you help me?
With what?
My camp is nearby in the ruins of Nilheim. Get me there safely, and you'll be rewarded.
You just...
It's just across the bridge and up that hill.
You're taking me to Nilheim, are you? Where the bandits are. Alright. Lead the way, good sir.
We're close now. I can see the camp.
One second. Inigo, I really don't trust this. Get ready to kill. As untasteful, as distasteful as it will be, we're gonna probably have to kill him. Yeah, yes, we're coming, we're heading right up. Lead the way.
Wait here, I'll be right back with your reward.
Yep.
Just the scratch.
Oh god.
That's all you've got.
This is not good. This is really not good. This is not what we wanted. Hold on. Oh, I don't have the... Okay. You're stuck on a rock. I will be more than happy to exploit that. I am not above it. Well, at least you know. Are you surrendering? I think you're surrendering.
Victory is yours. I submit.
Good. Hold on. I should be able to do something. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on.
We are rock.
Yes, I can. I can take his shit. No more. You are done. Flee for your life! Let's go kill the rest and save my friend Inigo. Think this over, friend. You should have thought it over. You doing all right? I'm sure you need help, but I can help. Hold on. There you go, buddy. That was a bit ruthless. There. Ooh. Cabbage soup. Well. All in all, Inigo, I don't think we did too bad. I totally called that guy betraying us though, didn't I? Yeesh. Alright. Carrots, apples, nothing. Oh my. Ooh. Yes. It seems this individual was a mage as well. Shame. Yes. I have my own wizarding staff now. Now, can I do any of the interesting stuff with it? No, I'm gonna need to learn those skills. I installed Staves of Skyrim, seeing as how I was using the walking stick as a shield anyways. I figured, you know what, let's get some mage staffs up in here. And we'll be able to learn some skills with Hello. Look at this thing, Inigo. This looks fine. Fine indeed.
You have something to say?
I have things to trade.
You want me to lighten your load?
Yes. Don't say it like that, though. It sounds weird when you say it. Take that. Take these. Take the... Apparently you can't. Are you over-encumbered already? How are you so over-encumbered already? But I need you to carry... the Nordic pit. Okay, whatever. Fine. Screw it. You don't need to. How about that? We'll drop this.
Next.
Alright. So we are done. We did the whole bounty. So I guess now we just gotta head back. Which is gonna be quite the journey. So lovely. Tell your friends to beware the lizard and the cat. The lizard wizard. There we go. Oh, we didn't have to take all the lives today, so that's always a plus. And we should be back in no time. Oh, you know what I should do? I should. Hotkey. My new staff. And capture some butterflies. Butterfly wings are quite useful. There we go. We caught them. Yay. What is this? I saw someone running. What's going on?
This place is boring. Nothing but the same thing every day. Have you decided if I can head up to Solitude yet? I hear it's the best place to meet someone who may be willing to teach me to paint. I'm sorry, dude.
You know, I have not found this place since my very first playthrough of Skyrim, and I forgot it existed.
Nor the year after that. You just care about this farm more than you care about me.
I remember this place specifically for, I was able to be a werewolf while being a vampire here. Because I might have been, like, one of the first to actually show off being a werewolf in Skyrim on YouTube. Hello.
We always use help picking crops if you need a few extra coins.
I have Nirn root to sell. No, I'm not. No.
I used to be. There isn't much time for that in my life anymore, I'm afraid. I actually owned a shop in Vivec City long ago, but I had to leave all that behind when the Red Mountain erupted. Perhaps someday I'll reopen a shop here in Skyrim.
You used to have a shop in Vivec City. Someone who's more familiar with Morrowind, tell me if this person actually was in Morrowind.
Is it that obvious? I've got my hands full here. Between the farm chores, cultivating my supply of Nirn root, keeping a tight rein on my sister Adori, there's little time for rest.
I could help, possibly.
Really? That would be a pleasant change. One of the ingredients I need to cultivate Nirn root are Jazz Bay grapes. The acidic content of the juice is perfect for the soil. I need 20 of them for my current crop.
20?
Good luck finding those Jazz Bay grapes. They're very rare.
Yeah, thanks for that. Jazz Bay grapes. Inigo, we're off to find adventure! Finding grapes. Huzzah!
Don't forget to hit that like, and remember to subscribe.